Hi, I'm Jules with Young Women's Resource Center. I'm a childbirth educator and doula.
Hi, I'm Clark, and I'm with the Young Women's Resource Center as well. I'm a doula and a childbirth educator too, and we're both on the Young Moms team.
Today we're going to talk a little bit about what a doula is. So the word doula comes from an ancient Greek term, and it means woman who serves. So today's doula serves birthing people. So they're educated and trained in emotional, physical, and postpartum support for moms during pregnancy. Doulas are not medical professionals. They do not perform cervical checks. They don't do ultrasounds. They don't do anything medical. So I think that's really important to remember when you start thinking about hiring a doula. Doulas make a huge impact in births. Doulas are educating you during your pregnancy, making a bond with you, supporting you. And then as labor starts, they support you in early labor. They support you in active labor. They support you during birth and postpartum. So it's pretty, they're on the journey with you. The doulas lower C-section rate by 32%, which is pretty amazing if you think about it. They also reduce the rate of medical interventions, lower the need for pain medications, and empower moms to have a voice during their birth. They also promote breastfeeding, which moms usually have a higher rate of successful breastfeeding when a doula is involved. So the main goal is to help moms have a positive birth experience. So I think that doulas are amazing. I'm a doula, so you know I can say that, right? But also as a mom, I had a doula with my first child, and my doula made a huge impact in my birth, just helping me feel calm and confident, just helping me make sure that I had a voice in my birth and I could do what I wanted.
In our program here, we have the Young Women's Resource Doula Program. And within our program, we provide doulas for free of no charge to our clients. But however, the doulas are paid separately. So with that being said, with our young moms, we feel like it is highly important for them to have any kind of support and advocacy, because sometimes it can be hard as a mother, especially if you're having to do it in adversity, alone, or just being young. It can be tough with balancing all of that. In our program, we allow the young moms to choose from doulas. We have a binder where each doula is listed with their picture and all of their skills, so they can figure out what matches best with them. Some of our doulas are also lactation counselors like Jules here. Some of our doulas are able to help with mental health. Some of our other doulas are also able to help with breastfeeding support just in general. Even if they aren't a lactation counselor, they still have a lot of knowledge.
I would like to talk about how if you're a Young Women's Resource Center participant, you're able just to sign up for it. It's for free, like I mentioned before. It's a wonderful program. A lot of our girls have mentioned the success and are highly appreciative of our doulas. Our doulas, when they get a doula, they're allowed to contact our doulas at any time. They can text, they can call, they can say, hey, I need your help. I want you to come to one of my doctor's appointments. Can you take me to one of my doctor's appointments? And we're able to do that for them. A lot of our moms go through a lot of things, especially if they're on their second child. With their first child, they may not have had a doula, and they're like, wow, I really need some help this time. Birth can sometimes be very tough to go through alone, as I mentioned before. Just dealing with providers or dealing with nurses and not really knowing what's here from there or what to expect in a birth. So we just want to make it as comfortable as possible and make sure that you're always advocated for, that you don't have to do anything you don't want to do, whether it be weight, get your blood pressure checked that day, take multiple sugar tests, multiple cervix checks. It's all on you on what you want to do and let you have that autonomy over your body and yourself. That's highly important as a woman, is to have autonomy for sure.
I agree.
So we just kind of want to give you guys a little fun sneak peek on what we keep in our doula bag. We don't just do this for our Young Women's Resource Center participants. We also do this for clients all over. So doulas all have a doula bag that they keep their goodies in. So we're going to start, and Jules is going to get to tell you guys about some of the fun things we do. So let's start with this big old thing.
Yeah. So really quick. So all doula bags are a little bit different. Mm-hmm. Everybody prefers to have some different things in their doula bags. But this is just a little example. So this is a rebozo. So doulas use this in labor. They can do a hip squeeze. They can give you some pressure on your bottom while you're in labor. It's called shake the apple tree. It's really fun. And it feels really good for some moms. So we really like rebozos. We can also use a sheet instead of a rebozo. Yeah. So not all doulas bring a rebozo with them. Sheets work just as well.
And these also just scarves, like a scarf that you have on. You can put it on the door and really make it work.
So it's pretty great. A fan! Fans are so great. So hospitals don't always have a fan. And labor, you kind of go from hot to cold to hot to cold. Fans are super handy. I use my doula fan a lot. Moms are like, I need that. So super convenient.
This is one of my favorites.
Yeah, so sometimes we have different types of massage tools. These can be used on your back. They can be used on your hips. They can be used all over. Very helpful when you have some pain. Oh yeah, another different version of a massage tool. Sometimes actually I've had moms use this particular one as a distraction. So during contractions, they just like rub their hand on it. It's just something to keep their mind off of what's happening during the contraction and help their mind go somewhere else. So these are kind of fun for different uses. So essential oils. So different doulas use different types of essential oils. Me as a doula, I usually use lavender and peppermint. Those are like the two staples. We don't ever put essential oils on our clients. We put them on a cotton ball so they can smell it in the room. And then if you decide at any time you're like, I hate that smell, I just put it in a Ziploc bag and throw it away. Can't smell it anymore. Yes, this is to set the mood. So like candles, dimming the lights, helping you feel nice and relaxed. Hospital lights are very, very bright and very hot, and most people feel stress in that situation, so we can kind of help set the mood. We put some battery operated candles out. Kind of sounds funny, but it actually really helps. Hot and cold packs. If your doula doesn't have us in their bag, your hospital can provide them too, but they're super handy. Sometimes you want heat in your back. Sometimes you want cold on your neck. So having versatile things are super helpful.
And something else that we add that's not in this bag particularly, sometimes we bring diffusers so that we can diffuse the air in the room. Sometimes we'll also have sheets ready. So we'll get hot sheets from the hospital so that the mom can be warm in times that she might feel cold, because you do get cold in birth.
Right. Yeah.
We also just bring balls for the water when they're in the tub. Anything, it's literally anything that you can put in your doula bag that could be helpful. Speaker, I almost forgot about that. Speaker, healing tones, music, just white noise. Moms love all of that. And we're here to provide all of that for you in the Young Women's Resource Center in the doula program and doulas in general for our general practice. So this is something we really love to do and something we greatly enjoy.
Well, thank you. If you guys have any questions for us, feel free to always contact us at Young Women's Resource Center. We're here to support you and help you have a great birth.
Exactly, thank you.